So a couple of days ago, I was invited out to Treyarch to record some of the Eclipse DLC a little bit early. Today, we're going to be taking a look at some of that footage and covering Verge, the brand new reimagined Banzai from Call of Duty World at War. Now, if you've never played Banzai, here's a couple screenshots of what the map originally looked like. You had a huge wooden bridge going across to two different sides, a nice beautiful waterfall coming down in the background, as well as caves going in the back as well that would allow you to switch from side to side and try to flank enemies. It was one of the most visually appealing maps in Call of Duty World at War, and it made for some of the best engagements in that game as well. But when it comes down to Verge in Call of Duty Black Ops 3, it, doesn't really feel like Banzai all that much. I mean, honestly, there are hints of it here and there, going through the caverns and, of course, walking across the bridge for the first time. You remember, wow, I did this on Banzai, but it looks so different and it's done so different from what Banzai was. It honestly feels like a completely new experience. And with that new experience comes a medium to larger size map. Verge is a pretty large map, but I still had a lot of fun playing Domination and Search and Destroy. Overall, I feel like you're able to perform a little bit better while using an assault rifle or an SMG. There are plenty of different sniper rifle spots here as well, though. A lot of really long engagements and tight corridors when it comes down to the caverns and everything that you can run through to try to flank your enemies. And surprisingly enough, when I found out where most of the fighting was taking place, I was pleasantly surprised. Unless you're playing Domination, you won't see that many people fighting on the bridge. A lot of it's going to be taking place under the bridge, in the water supply, which is very, very weird. The caverns are also a hot spot when it comes down to just fighting enemies with SMGs or shotguns, but surprisingly, a lot of the fighting takes place under the bridge because a lot of people are trying to flank at the same time when people are going up above it, which is very, very interesting, and I didn't think that that would be something that would happen. So even though there's a lot that this map does that's right, there are some things that I think it does that is wrong. Like I said at the beginning, this is a medium to larger size map, and that's fine and dandy, but it does allow for a lot of open air, meaning that you're going to be running through caverns, looking for enemies, swimming through the water. There's a lot of different places you could go, and that's going to take a lot of time to search for enemies, especially in a 6v6. This is a map that's going to definitely be well suited for ground war, but for other things like TDM, kill confirmed, free-for-all, kill-based modes pretty much in general, it's gonna cause a lot of pain and a lot of 10-minute round matches that are just going to be unavoidable. As for other game modes like Search and Destroy, Domination, and even Uplink, you're gonna have a blast. This was a great map overall for all of those objective-based game modes, especially in a 6v6, but Ground War is definitely gonna be shining right here on this map because, like I said, you got a lot of open air. You got the water you can swim in, you got the caverns you can traverse, you got the wall running opportunities on the bridge, you got the wall running opportunities over by the waterfall area, you have the little building areas, and it just goes on and on with so many different places that enemies could be, and that's why I think kill-based modes are going to be a little more challenging with this particular map. Now, the other gripe that I have, and it's a really stupid and small one, but it's just something that brings back the whole nostalgic factor for me with World at War, was the fact that they turned off the waterfall feature. They took the waterfall out of it completely, put these two pipes here that only drip and leak a little bit. There's really not that huge flowing waterfall that made Banzai what it was back in the day. And I think that would have been a very good opportunity, not only for that wall run spot right there, but for the two doors that connect underneath. It could have completely blocked the view of anyone coming through. It could have made for some really cool kill cams if you knew someone was through there using a thermal sight or something. But I think overall, that water should have been turned on. It should have been the last clean water supply coming through, because with the water sitting as it is stagnant right now, and the fact that it's crystal clear, that kind of concerns me. So I don't know what to say. I really do like this map. It's going to be great for objective-based modes. As for kill-based modes, I don't know. It's going to be a completely different story, especially when the map first comes out. We all know how many people camp and wait to kind of survey the area to see if enemies run through a certain portion. But overall, I'm pretty excited for it. I think that you guys will enjoy it as well. I wanted to just share some gameplay with you all today, and I wanted to know what you guys think about Verge as well. So leave a comment down below. If you guys enjoyed this video here today, make sure to click the like button down below as well and subscribe. For more awesome videos coming each and every day, we're going to be taking a closer look at Knockout tomorrow. You're not going to want to miss that video. So until tomorrow, guys, I will see ya. Peace.